everyone, and welcome to KY Talks. I am Sonal Ambekar, your host for this interview. Today's interview is powered by MD Investments, founded by Mr. Mandar Datar, an excellent insurance and investments agent. Find the link to MD Investments down below in the description box. Let's begin with today's KY Talk. Today, our guest is Mrs. Kruti Shah. She's the founder of Forward Steps Preschool. Hi, Kruti. Welcome to KY.
Hi.
So, a little background. Having an out-of-the-box approach towards life, music, dance, singing, fine arts are her passion, while hardworking is her nature. She has done her master's in human development from SNDT University, Mumbai. She has a total of 12 years of experience in the field of education. While doing master's, she dreamt of having her own school, which would be different in terms of teaching techniques, like more practical and hands-on experience to be given to the children for better development. As a school which helps children to be independent and get ready for the world. A school where they learn beyond ABC and excel in various fields rather than just the academics. With this idea, inception of Forward Steps took place in June 2019. It's the first organic school in Navi Mumbai. The kind of approach that they follow helps children gain a deeper understanding of the concepts and build on the knowledge which they already have. Values of empathy, morality, sharing, giving back to the society is what they emphasize on. Let's get to know more from Kruti. Hello, Kruti. So,
Hi, so
tell us about how this journey started. Mainly, I want to know what was your motivation to, you know, be an entrepreneur. So we know that you have done the regular 9-to-5 job life. You've experienced that as well. And then you shifted your, you know, fields and you came into this entrepreneurship. You started something of your own. What was your motivation exactly?
So this begins, I had seen this dream when I was doing my master's in human development. So that time I had this dream that I would want to have a school with a kind of, different teaching techniques, with more profound teaching, which is like little beyond the ABC version, like, you know, a general abacadabra sort of a thing. Where it's more natural process, because with this digital world, though we ourselves are into digital world right now, but still the essence of nature, the essence of natural play, the essence of, like, you know, growing naturally, right, was the keen interest.
Right.
So from then on, when I started my journey, I worked with all kinds of children, be it physically or mentally challenged, be it regular, even the adults. I was doing my job. So all these things. And then maybe, you know, when that thing just says that when you're so determined, maybe if it is in your destiny. So I believe in destiny, to be very honest. So well, then on that, if the universe
it's meant
wants
to be,
it,
yeah, right,
then it happens. So I think the universe wanted it and it happened. And yes, definitely, I was highly supported by my husband,
wow,
my family. So yeah, here it is in front of you. And this makes me very happy and proud. And it gets, so basically, children is one thing that keeps me motivated, is their smile, their innocence. So as you know, what, Sonal, when we grow old, the innocence is one factor which starts diminishing.
Right, okay, right.
We
it starts
try
fading
to be more fun. Absolutely. So I wanted all the time, like, you know, there needs to be a little bit of innocence alive around me or with me or in me. So I think children is the best source to, you know, keep getting that all the time with just their smiles, with their cute little talks.
And the curiosity, they are always coming up with newer
absolutely
questions.
Right. It's like where our window shuts,
yeah,
there is always
open.
There,
yeah,
we just open it. Like,
right,
you know, it's like that. We
right,
quite adulterated.
Like, yeah, and like you said, to have that sensitivity within us, to have that little bit of an innocence. They say now that when you're with a child, you tend to talk like a child, you tend to act like a child. The child inside you comes out. That, you know, is hidden
absolutely
for most of your life.
And that, I believe, is absolutely alive in me. And that keeps me alive, to be very
right
honest. Like, you know, even online, though online, but at least we can see children and we can talk to them each day is something
yes
more motivating than just like absolutely no types.
Right. And since we spoke about the sensibility, the sensitivity within us while talking to kids, it's also important. So, like we said, that the emphasis that your school gives is on morality and value education mainly. So, it's also important that we nurture these kids in a way that they also embrace their sensitive sides, which is so important for given that mental health has come up into the spotlight. So that also is one, you know, connecting factor over here, right?
Absolutely, absolutely.
So, Kruti, what would you say gives you a sense of accomplishment? Say, at the end of the day, what makes you feel that, oh, yes, I'm doing the right thing?
So, just before this, you spoke about how they embrace and what they, like, you know, learn the values. I think I'll share one, though we have many, but I'll share definitely one incident that happened pre-pandemic when we just started. So, one fine day, children are playing outdoor. And one child found a dead insect over there. So now what happened was he pointed out and all others gathered. And now that led to another discussion of what is to be done now to that body of the insect. So these are, I'm just talking, these are 2.5 year olds. Okay. Yes. These
tiny
are not
little older. Dots.
Yes, absolutely. And the discussion and the questions of the teachers started, and we were like you know, getting care. Let's reach, where should we go with this dead body of the insect? Right. So through a lot of discussions, they had an understanding that definitely insects' home is a garden.
Right.
Okay. They obviously don't live in our homes. They live in the garden. So finally, everybody came to a conclusion that let's bury this insect under the ground. So we have a gardening area and they have this mini tools, the rakes and shovels and all those things.
Wow.
So they got ready. We actually went out of the school premises. We found a spot. We kind of dug the ground. And there is a beautiful frangipani tree, champa tree just beside our school. So then, so we don't pluck flowers because obviously they hurt. Okay, it gets hurt. So, but whatever flowers naturally come down, they fall off.
Right.
So, few of them we collected. So, we buried the insect and we put the flowers and we put the water. Now, this incident, when it happened, it got completed. Children went home, done. The next day in the evening, one of our mother just came in the evening to keep her child for the karate class, and she asked him, ma'am, what exactly have you taught? As like, I can't understand, what is it? So it's like an incident happened at her place. So she's like, yesterday night I killed the cockroach with hit, and my daughter, she came running, she took the cockroach in a dustpan and put it in the rose plant. And she was like, absolutely, what did she? And we are all wondering, what is she doing? And this is what I told her, that this thing happens. So, like, respecting even the body, the dead body, right, empathizing with what is afterlife. Maybe right, it's not that so intricate or so deep,
right,
but that understanding to respect every living being around,
yes,
you. And when she said that, and many parents do come and talk about all these things, I think that absolutely gives us the sense of accomplishment. Because our mission is like to develop capable individual who can impart purpose and knowledge to their world as well as life. Now you can decide with this when the 2.5 just did this action without saying anything.
Right.
So that day when the mother said that, now I will make sure that I will not kill any of the pest with hit, especially in front of my children.
Right.
Isn't it that the child taught so much to that mother?
Exactly. Right. And you're teaching them to empathize with their surroundings, which is so important given climate change and all of these things. It is important that we respect our surroundings. We respect the nature that is always the environment that we live in. And
absolutely,
to know that you're teaching this tiny little tots at the age of 2.5. And like they say, ke bache dekh ke seekhte hai. They see what
absolutely
is being done and they learn. Like you said, that the little girl, she saw what had happened the previous day and then she did the same thing at home, which is always going to stay with her. Like they say, teachers shape of kids. Right.
The wonder is that, you know, sometimes we adults kind of underestimate these thoughts.
Yes.
We shouldn't. Sometimes, almost every time they are there to teach us something which is unsaid.
Right.
All the things we have to have is open our eyes and ears and that kind of understanding towards them.
Right.
And especially listen to them, what, because they always tells you something really important and not just like shoo away. Okay, talk something else. Like, you know, we shouldn't be doing this to them.
And we should encourage them to ask questions, because they innocently just come up to the parents or the elders and they have these questions when sometimes we also don't know how to answer these questions. But that also gets our minds running. We it makes us scratch our minds.
Absolutely. Absolutely. They have multiple questions to ask, you know. So we need to be there to answer them with that kind of a simple understanding.
Right.
Yes, sometimes we are not equipped with that kind of a knowledge. No worries. For time being, we can just, you know, we can tell the child, tomorrow will surely I'll come up with the answer, you know.
Yeah.
That kind of attitude or that kind of thinking to be there, that
helps,
the child can be full of curiosity. Why the puddle is brown? Why this pigeon is not coming inside? Or, you know, they have multiples. So basically our school is built, I mean, it is in such a way that it's quite open school, so we don't have those shades and all those things. So they get enough. So we have an outdoor pottery section where the mango tree is on our head.
Wow.
So children have been under this, that they, so when we pluck mangoes, that's where your harvest goes in place. So we do cut the mangoes and they eat it on the spot, understanding where the mangoes come from.
So much in touch with nature.
Beautiful. Absolutely.
Right. So Kruti, tell me, like when you started leaving a 9-to-5 job, which is considered to be the most secure, you know, source of income, is what it seems like and is what the society thinks of it lies. And it is true in a way. Leaving that and, you know, starting something of your own, which encompasses of a lot of uncertainty of how it will work, when will you get that, you know, stable income source. So what would you say were the difficulties between this journey, and how has it been like?
A lot difficult. Thinking of a dream and putting into an execution is a total two different stuffs. So right from finding the place, right from fighting all the suggestions that comes across you, do it in a garage, do it in a small place, don't take so big, like, you know, such a big risk, etc. Fighting all those things was not easy. After that also, when we've got this, like, you know, we've started the school, we are going to turn two in this June.
Wow.
So, So then the management, the kind of responsibility that you gain. So in job, we had this, like, we report our heads, things that they sort the outer part, like being, talking to parents and etc.
Right.
But you have to build that culture amongst the staff, with the parents, at the same time need to build that kind of a culture where children feel at their home. That kind of great responsibilities that you have to answer your parents' queries to make them feel comfortable that yes, forward steps is something, like, you know, it is that important place where my child will definitely benefit in terms of simple as in terms of happiness. Not beyond that, like, you know, that way. Then once we had, so this is, as I said, it's an organic school. And organic means both approach-wise as well as setup. So it's very, very difficult. We never assigned any interiors, because Forward Step, interior people. So Forward Steps is our own baby. So now to raise your own baby is a real task. So two things that if I would want to share is we have lovely stuffs over here in terms of utility box, which we actually made it from a 40 mango crates. So we actually went, we got it, we have went to different places to acquire these kind of resources where these approaches are richly followed, like, you know. So we we went to places, different places across India to get those sources available. Then the design was put out on paper. Then we were like, it was absolutely one-on-one interaction with us and the workers, and no such expert
middlemen or anything like that.
Yeah, people in between to design the corners and stuff. Now, this was a wonderful journey, but as you said, we totally believe, like, you know, when there's no struggle, there's no satisfaction. There's no strength, basically. So within 8 months down the line, the world was hit with pandemic, and so we too. So that led to another challenge of online classes, which I think everybody faced the same challenge.
The digital era had started. Yeah.
Absolutely. So we crossed that also with the highest success rate, because that is what we are into. So basically, we train teachers for all these things, that how you can productively engage your child even on screen.
Right.
So we provided them with all the materials and stuff, and it was a huge success. And yes, the pandemic continues. So the barriers are still on, and we are still standing.
Yeah, the pandemic continues, and so does our, you know, will to, you know, make a difference.
Absolutely, absolutely. And standing quite strong against you, do whatever you want. So that kind of the whole attitude, or the whole kind of a thing, has been transformed into me. That kind of patience has been developed
in you, right?
So, you know, all these things are together. They're just, you know, twined together when we just proceed.
Right. So I really want to ask you, since you said it's an organic school, I want to ask you in detail, if you can tell us how your method of teaching is different from the traditional method of teaching. If you can give us an in detail example of how exactly you do it different.
Okay. So the thought actually occurred over the, over the period of experiences that I had. So as you are aware, as you're aware that I was doing a job, and always this question used to, you know, trigger me a lot. So I'm very self-analyzed person, and every night I would want to go back to my day and what was the, the learning and what did I achieve and etc. Right. So this one question always triggered, if my children knows that, if they know about colors, and I'm showing them the same colors. The world is getting digital. Before child goes to a school, to a preschool, child is aware of many, 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 many things.
Yeah.
Okay. It's not only the digital, but it's a regular mother's talk.
Right.
Parents do talk about this show. So then what is that the child learned today in school? By showing the colors, what is my contribution to the child's learning was always a big question.
Yeah, right.
Okay.
So now it's a thing that parents start teaching their kids ABCD 1, 2, 3, 4 since they are 1 or 2 years. So they already know that. So what's more
so
that is being added?
No, but they don't know how to apply.
Apply, right.
Also, they have a knowledge, a part knowledge, okay, fine, this is, say, pink. But how did the pink derive? They don't know.
Right,
the colors came into this play. So, yeah, there are factories and now, but what about earlier time? Colors is not just because factories made them and,
It's because we saw them in the nature.
Absolutely. So that's where the nature falls in place. Right. A simple sort of a beetroot, which is there in your kitchen, kind of let's make this pink color. Let's make our own colors. So that includes our children go through the process of weaving, carpentry, pottery, cooking, all 4 right from 2 years. Okay, because these are life skills. These are highly creative sources. So if I say weaving, which we definitely there are steps. There are steps for 2, 3, 4. It doesn't, weaving doesn't mean that they simply take the needle and then start sewing. Or weaving. It is not that way. There are definitely a step-by-step process which they have to lead. But a simple, say, color making, now grating of the beetroot, it is the motor development. It is that you are getting independent. It is that you can help your mama, and your mama is your mama and not a maid. The idea of mama give me this, mama give me that, do this, do that. Because, see, mothers are so concerned and they have a habit of carrying children throughout till whatever age they feel.
Right.
But I think in 2 years, children are capable and they are ready for the world, the real world.
Right.
All we have to do is gently give them those experience.
Right.
So that doesn't make into a cruel world. It is quite a meaningful to them.
Right, right.
So like a simple thing that in our school, when the child is doing, say, weaving, the child goes till, say, 10th standard, for example. And now there are two children, one passed out from the regular school and one who has done all these things across the, life for these many years. Now, you imagine when both of them want to go to a fashion designing institute and want to opt, whose skills are better?
The one who's not weaving since a young age.
Absolutely.
Right.
So this education is not limiting. That is why we said we don't limit to ABC. And weaving, a new word when a two-year-old child says.
Right.
Isn't it better than watch? So we don't say that we will not introduce to watch. But it is always nice to introduce them to different vocabulary.
Right.
So maybe a term called hybrid, with the understanding of what is hybrid.
Hybrid, right. Wow.
And not just a horse.
That's
so
wonderful.
We definitely do the experiment of hybrid. We wait, that develops patience in child.
Right.
Like, oh my God, we have to really wait for like 1 month. And
one,
we daily keep, you know, looking at the plant or whatever things are like, you know, growing. So this is a process and it's a wonderful process.
It's
and
a wholesome process, I'd say. I mean, the way you explained it.
So I have one thing to just show you. Our teachers have made this wonderful thing. So see, what is this, Sonal?
It's the earth.
Absolutely. Okay. So this last month when we had our earth day. So now, earth, few kids know, few kids don't. So agree, this is earth, this is a land, this
land.
Is water.
Water.
But now, our teachers are trained in such a way to ask questions. What do you think? The question is, what do you think? Land is more or water is more on the earth? Now, how to figure it out? So then we keep the sensory stuffs for them, say maybe rice or the pasta, and they start filling from those two big jars that we have. And then they understand and they come up that I'm putting a lot more of the rice in the section of blue, the blue rice, and the greener. So the jar is like just not getting over.
Oh,
and I'm keeping, so they come up that my rice went more over here than this. So then we write our answer.
Wow.
So
I mean, I've never heard of such a way of, making
absolutely.
A kid run its mind. Wow. That's wonderful.
Absolutely. Also with the understanding, if we would want to go a little beyond that, you know, who all stays on land? So they would come up with some animals and who all stays in water. Okay. But there's someone staying both. So then what are they called? Amphibians when they stay here and here. So a simple things at the age of 2, 3, because see, they know what is earth. They know the color of it. Yeah. But what about its elements? What about its, what more earth has?
Wow.
So it has different, so the water continues to flow everywhere, but it separates the land.
Right. I am slowly falling in love with forward step schools.
Absolutely. So actually there was one incident when we said that how can we connect this land to this land?
Right.
Now, this is another question.
Oh, the bridge.
So
oh, wow.
Actually got the bridge. So he constructed a bridge and he said, we can just cross over the bridge, which is the life.
Right,
which
right.
Which is so true.
Wow.
And these are just three-year-olds.
I mean, you're actually
without
making
exactly.
these kids, like we can say that you're preparing these kids for the world. I mean, the pandemic has shown us how uncertain things can be, and knowing life skills is so important. And to know
absolutely.
That you're completely preparing them at a very young age, so they will grow up only in that, you know, in that mold. That, oh, we know the life skills. And
so we are trying our best. We have started somewhere. Let's keep
That's
our fingers
wonderful.
Crossed that we reach.
Ruthi, so you must interact with so many kids, and what would you say, or how would you say has this journey changed you as a person, or what are the changes that you see in yourself?
A lot. As I had mentioned earlier also, I've become more patient. The challenges are so much that I cannot be what I was somewhere before, to be very honest, taking quick decisions or, you know, like just getting over with it, or maybe just not even kind of paying heed to some things, like, because the job life, as I said, like, you know, there are heads on you who take this. But then when I landed on this platform, on this, when I was making this forward steps, and afterwards, the challenge is like building relationship with parents. So basically, they are sending their precious soul to us. So which is the double and triple in the rawest form that it can be.
It's so
absolutely
raw.
Absolutely. So it's a triple amount of responsibility on our shoulders to kind of refine this raw. Not only this. So we always, when parents come and take admissions, so from day one, we always happily say, welcome to the Forward family. Now, it doesn't stop with just paying fees and just, you know, attending open days. We truly and genuinely reach out to them and open our doors open for them to reach us, you know. So the amount of responsibility, patience, that kind of faith and trust, all these things have, like, you know, developed so strongly in me, and I'm still learning. I'm still learning from the like, you know, lows that, okay, now this could have been handled this way, you know, this could have been this thing. I think this was not a topic to, so the constant like, you know, thinking of those things, that this was not a great like conversation, it's okay, it's just a child or just an incident. So some things to let go that I have learned, some things to take it really seriously, some things to be like, you know, be with parent, make them feel that, yes, we are truly with you. Don't worry. And, you know, these days, it's not parents' fault, you know. It's a general like, you know, upbringing of the children, that maybe if a mother just sees another mother and she feels that, okay, this parenting style is good. It's just because parents themselves are learning. They are themselves learning. So, to guide them into that kind of, I will not use the term correct, because parenting is not, it does not have a term right or wrong. Yeah. But some kind of a relevant path should, which suits to that particular situation. And we always tell parents to try. Come back and try. So this kind of courage that I was not having, like, before, or that kind of, you know, confidence that I have developed, is all the changes that I have seen after getting into this venture.
Wow, that's wonderful. I mean, like we, in the beginning, as we said, that the sensitivity that kids bring within us is what is also, you know, growing inside you. We can see that. So, Kruti, coming to the end of this talk, what would be your message for our audience, or say for budding entrepreneurs? How would you encourage them to, you know, take that step ahead?
So, Sonal, I am not, maybe I'm not a right person to kind of, like, you know, give an advice or so. But yeah, since you have asked me, I would just say that, you know what, especially women, if you have dreamt of something, be it anything, be it a small thing and leading to any kind of a venture, just give it a try. Give 365 days to yourself. Convince your family, give them, because 365 days is not a big thing in your life. Just give it, because this 365 days, you will learn your strength and weaknesses. Maybe you will understand that I need to take it up to this level. Maybe you will feel like, no, I gave it a try, it's okay, I don't want to continue. Maybe, but that's fine.
Exactly.
Even in terms of family, family will gain that trust if you start developing. So they will be also ready by the end of the 365th day that, okay, go for it. And maybe they'll also understand that, okay, we gave her the chance and she discovered for her own. So I'm just like saying, give it a try. Believe me, because as I said, if you want it, you know, if you ask for it, you get it. That's true. So then just go for it. Don't be, yes, you will have, it's sitting here, I will not, I have my family, I have my school life. So a lot of difficulty in terms of managing this as well. And, but we women are truly blessed by God with that kind of a superpower to balance this life.
Yeah.
All you have to do is accept that I am not a superwoman. I'm a human being. It's okay. okay if I make mistakes in both the places or at one place. And sometimes it's okay to give importance to your career or maybe to your venture rather than the family. Home or right. the other way around. Right. But it is okay. That yeah. acceptance needs to be within you to convince the family.
Right, right. That's very, it. Very well said. I liked how you give this message to the woman out there who, like, we speak about empowerment, but this is how we should, you know, help each other grow.
Absolutely.
Thank you, Kruti. Thank you so much for coming here on KYE Talk and sharing your insightful thoughts and mainly telling us about how you're helping our future generations to, you know, grow in such an empowering way, I'd say.
Thank you so much. And thank you for having me on this platform. I really loved it. I mean, the way KYE is like, you know, getting all of us together and we are, the way you said that we can learn from each other, exactly. connecting human to human is something really nice thing to be on. So, and yes, I'm loving it.
Thank you, Kruti.